Many landowners ask, why do we need to manage our wild pig populations in the state of Texas? You know, we do have some individuals that like wild pigs from a hunting standpoint, and that's fine. But by and large, when we're talking about an exotic that has established itself throughout many of our states, and particularly in Texas with such a large population, the agriculture and ecological cost associated with having this invasive exotic established among our native wildlife populations is severe. The agriculture damage is tremendous, whether it's row crops, whether it's damage to pastures and hay meadows, whether it's the potential for spreading disease among livestock. Those are all real agricultural dangers in the state of Texas. But in addition, the threat they pose ecologically by competing with our own native wildlife species is substantial. For example, wild pigs ecologically can cause damage to our wetlands and sensitive areas by causing sedimentation due to their rooting activity. They can increase the nitrate levels in our waterways by their rooting activity, and they can even change the vegetation component of many of our communities by outcompeting native species for large seeded trees such as oaks and hickories, and actually reduce their composition across the landscape. And many of our native species rely on these particular plant species for food and cover. So direct competition by other species in direct relation to wild pigs is an issue, either for this mass component such as acorns in the fall and winter, can be substantial for a number of our species such as white-tailed deer, squirrels, and birds. And in addition, with a state like Texas that has such a large white-tailed deer management program and an industry associated with hunting that species, our white-tailed deer hunting industry is valued at over $2 billion annually in the state of Texas. And so when you have a large wild pig population sharing the landscape with that white-tailed deer herd, you're bound to have an overlap in diet and competition for living space. And in fact, white-tailed deer and wild pigs share some 83 million acres of habitat across Texas. For landowners trying to manage native species such as white-tailed deer, their tolerance for an invasive exotic such as wild pigs needs to be very, very low. So for those landowners that have wild pigs present, they're trying to manage for native species like white-tailed deer, they need to be on a campaign to reduce that wild pig population to as low levels as possible. So ecologically and environmentally and agriculturally, there's a number of reasons we need to be limiting the size of our wild pig populations in the state of Texas.